Very good afternoon. I'm very happy to welcome all of you to this webinar on the CII Center for Competitiveness for SMEs. This is presently headquartered in Chandigarh, and we work out of the Northern Region Office of CII, and this is really housing competitiveness capabilities which are available through a service for the SME membership of CII. We are also working with non-CII members, but our primary focus is the SME members. This center is also an ISO 9000:2008 certified, and we do have to face an audit, so we follow very strict quality processes to ensure that quality of service is maintained. What is really our vision? The vision of this center is to become the single point of reference for meeting the competitiveness needs of the small and medium enterprise. As a single point of reference, we mean it should be a one-stop shop for the SMEs. If they come to this center, it should meet all their competitiveness requirements. So SMEs want to be able to do so many things. Okay? So what is it that we are going to be focusing on? For instance, they may want everything. They may want business development, they may want finance, they may want IT, they may want, you know, operational efficiencies, etc. But we are focused right now on certain areas which is illustrated in our mission and our activities. So the mission is to provide a range of services that enhance the capability of the small and medium enterprises to become world-class through engagement with all stakeholders and global partners. So our stakeholders today are the government members, it is the banks, it is IT companies, and we do have some global partnerships which we will talk about in this presentation. So we do provide a range of services through our own experts and also experts who we engage from outside on specific areas. These are some of the government supported schemes which are which our center is promoting. DCMSME stands for the Development Commissioner Office. As maybe some of you are aware, the Ministry of the Micro, Small and Medium Enterprise has two parts. There is an office which is the Secretary of the MSME, and there is another office which is called the Development Commissioner of the MSME. So the Development Commissioner of the MSME funds projects for SMEs and SME associations through a variety of programs which are there on their website. We are associated with three of them. There is one scheme which is called the Quality Management Systems or the Quality Tools and Technique Awareness Programs, which we do with the Ministry of SME. And these programs are run across the country, mostly in Tier 2, Tier 3 cities, and there is an annual program that we sign up with them, and then we have the programs done in partnership with the regions. The second scheme which has recently opened up to for us, and that is the Lean Manufacturing Cluster Scheme. The Lean Manufacturing Clusters are, the government has recognized that we can improve the competitiveness of the SMEs through Lean Manufacturing Clusters. And the CFC has the capabilities to support these clusters. So in the past 4 or 5 years, we actually did only one such lean manufacturing cluster with the government. And that too, it was in Calcutta. It was run by a company called Moonlight for their suppliers. And we were invited to be the consultants to help them out. But now we have actually put in proposals to the ministry to really work as a lean manufacturing consultancy organization so that we can do many more clusters. So this scheme is now open. It has funds. 80% of the funding is done by the government and only 20% fees needs to be paid by the companies. So I would very strongly urge and recommend people around the webinar today that please ask questions and please connect with us on this. Also on the QMS QTT awareness programs, if there are locations in CII who would like to have these programs, we can, in our proposals this year, we can put in those, we can include those locations. We also take international missions outbound and inbound. International, the outbound missions are again hugely subsidized by the ministry, and inbound missions actually come and visit Chandigarh. So almost every 2-3 months, we do have international delegations coming from the developing world, and they visit our center. We also are doing a very interesting program with the Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion, which is under the Ministry of Industry. It's called the Indo-German Manager Training Program. So all of these I will just illustrate to you in the next pages. So this is the outward delegations. So the objective of these missions is to help our companies understand the quality management systems and tools and techniques which are adopted by industry in developed countries. So this is a very recent delegation we took in the month of March to Japan, and this scheme is going to continue this year again. So if there is an interest to partner with us to participate in such a delegation, we are happy to work with the state offices and the regions to get the best out of this proposition. Next, inbound. So this was coming really from the African countries, as you can see. So this was almost about 40-50 people coming to our office in Chandigarh, and such a visit happens very frequently. As I mentioned, at least 2-3 months we have a mission coming in. The Indo-German Manager Training Program is again a very interesting program. It has a training component in India which is done by the Germans and the Indian people. The objective of the training program is to teach SMEs how to do business with Germany. So they, in the Indian component, they learn about, you know, what are the opportunities in Germany and how to negotiate, how to project yourself to the German businesses so that you are able to attract their attention and get business proposals with them. And then this is followed by training in Germany for about a month, and this is funded by the government of Germany. I think the companies have to pay only for their airfare, but the rest of it is all funded by the government of Germany. And at the end of it, for 1 year at least, there is a follow-up through alumni activities to make sure that these companies do end up with a positive result with German partners. So the alumni activity, of course, continues for forever. So we have been running this program for at least 6 years, and we have a very good response on this. Almost the results are 100% success, because every company who went to Germany through this program has reported their increase in their turnover, their increase in their investments abroad, increase in investments from Germany into India. Also, many of them have set up businesses in Europe. Many of them are using Germany to liberate the market space around the world. So these are basically normally engineering companies, but we've also had a special request from Germany to promote this with the mining companies, healthcare companies, and energy efficiency companies. So in 2013, we've taken a cumulative of 148 managers to this program. And it is really management development because they learn how to do business globally. So let me now change the topic. Okay, so the Indo-German program and the schemes with the government are all basically government support linked programs. We also have our own experts, and I think our experts are today one of the best in the world, and they are teaching topics like manufacturing excellence, HR management, total cost management, energy audits and management, corrosion management. Now, the primary focus is SMEs. Okay. So all these subjects have to be customized for the SMEs, and these counselors over the past 7-8 years have really, you know, developed this whole subject and its implementation and how to do the handholding with the companies in these areas. So some of you may see that, you know, energy audits is primarily the, you know, the service coming from the Green Business Center, but this center is doing it in coordination with the GBC, but primarily targeting the SME segment. So they are really complementing the work with the GBC, and so similarly also on TCM, whereas the Institute of Logistics is the center which is responsible for TCM, but this is being done for the SMEs through the CFC center. Corrosion management, of course, is a new subject which the center is working on, and they have a corrosion management committee which has 42 of India's best experts on corrosion as their members, and they are providing services like corrosion audits, etc. So let me go into this in some detail. So how do we engage with our members? There are five main ways that we do that. The first is training programs. There are open house programs, and we have a training calendar, and we are happy to share that with all of you. We also do in-company work, that is handholding in companies. Also, we do advisory service, which is again individual or in cluster formation. So clusters means about 6 to 12 companies would come together, form a cluster, and we would offer them support on a roadmap, which is a proven roadmap for bringing about the improvements in the cluster through the cluster approach. So it has become quite popular because it is a very cost-effective way for the SMEs to learn, and I think by working together, they also learn a lot from each other. So therefore, the speed of improvement becomes much faster. So we have roadmaps for clusters for 12 months, 18 months, 24 months, 36 months, and so on. So there are roadmaps through which we can take these companies towards becoming what we call as being ready for being, I would say, evaluated and I would say declared as complying to the Indian production system. So this is primarily manufacturing companies, and our work has been focused towards developing companies to become, you know, following the Indian production system. So audits and assessments is another service we offer to our members, and audits could be for quality, could be for productivity, could be overall operational efficiency and energy area, and audits for corrosion as well. And we also support the northern region for their award on Kaizens and 5S award. So our counselors are I would say capable, competent to participate in such assessments and audits, and also help to set up systems to do it. So for instance, working with the northern region to set up this award, that was one of the initiatives taken up by our counselors this year. So I think many of the regions are having such awards, and if there is a need to look at, you know, doing something in the areas of expertise of this center, it can be something that we could be open to. Okay, so in the Q&A, do please you know, bring in if you have any questions on this. Also, we have some e-learning modules, and also we do webinars on these subjects. Also, we do roadshows for our service. For instance, if you want to promote cluster services in your zone, in your district, we'd be happy to come and do roadshows to promote the services of the center. More than promote the services, really to identify companies who are needing this service and helping to meet their needs and requirements. And of course, we also do seminars, but I would say almost 80% of our business is really providing training and advisory service, audits, etc., through our own experts. So we have till today, this is a cumulative figure, 239 clusters formed by the CII Center for Competitiveness for SMEs, impacting 2,438 companies. And these are across the country, and ongoing 38 clusters which are covering 250 companies. As I described to you, that a cluster has a start point and an end point. So it usually lasts a year or year and a half. So these are clusters which have been formed since about 2004. These are the energy and corrosion management services. So on energy, in the last 5 years, through energy management services of the center, around 7,000 lakh annual savings has been reported from around 90 individual companies. And in the corrosion services, we've done 8 corrosion audits, 24 training programs, and nearly 720 organizations benefited. And we have 23 booklets on corrosion management, which have been written by these 42 national experts on corrosion for the SMEs. Okay, so do's and don'ts on corrosion management, those kind of knowledge is available in our center. Recent achievements, more than 250 training programs held in the last 3 years in the various verticals, nearly 1,600 senior and middle-level managers and 2,000 engineers benefited from training in corrosion and energy management respectively. 7 batches, about 150 people benefited through the Indo-German manager training program. And we started a new initiative through the Cluster Competitiveness Discovery Missions. So taking industrial delegations to companies to study much more than, you know, what was good manufacturing. Today, the definition of good manufacturing practices includes green manufacturing, lean manufacturing, energy conservation, supplier development, etc. So we teach companies how to evaluate such practices, and also we teach them how to implement this in their companies through such very specialized missions. This is our flagship program, the National Cluster Summit, and usually it is organized in September-October time frame in Delhi. Success stories, we do have brochures of the success stories, and these are again available for everybody. We are happy to share these, and we also have our own publications, which are really about, for instance, this is Godrej sharing their journey through excellence through the cluster approach, how the Godrej group of companies worked as a cluster. And now actually this year they have started supporting their own suppliers. Okay? And maybe they will also write that up. We also had this book, Best Practices in TQM, released here in the southern region. We also have the Supplier Quality Management Handbook done again with Godrej. And there are other books as well. So be happy to again share these internally. media. And thank you.